Ever since the Moto Guzzi V100 was announced, opinions have been split on the departure from the classic looks that Guzzi is known for. Luckily for us, we were invited for the APAC launch of the Moto Guzzi V100 Mandello for a chance to get to really know the bike in person. With the promise of an exceptional riding experience from KL to Genting on a modern and sophisticated machine, I jumped at the chance before I realized I don't get to ride up to KL.
It's my turn to go overseas and we're going to KL today. And I'm going to try going there by a method that I see all the young kids doing now. Young kids. I'm still young, lah. Is it like that?
Did I do it right?
I landed in KL. This is the start of the V100 journey. Oh man, I can't wait to see that bike, man. But I think there's someone from Moto Guzzi here to pick me up.
Okay, look for the Moto Guzzi sign. Hey! I see him. Hey, bro.
What's up? Mr. Jake?
Thank you so much. Okay, where are we going?
I'd like to experience what Amos and Winston experience flying to KL. I sure, but I prefer riding.
I just reached the hotel, holy crap.
Guys, the room is amazing. This hotel, oh my god.
Golf course!
Thanks, Eugene. This is awesome. Can't wait to get riding.
So there's an interview later, if I'm not wrong, with Mr. Arturo, who is the product lead, I believe, of the V100.
I've actually been looking at the V100 ever since it was announced. I feel like Moto Guzzi isn't really a brand that's very popular in Singapore. But the V7 was actually one of the bikes that I was considering for my class 2. And apart from that, also the V85 was part of my considerations. So now that the V100 is out, I can't wait to try it.
Even though I'm not really a fan of how it looks,
I'm gonna prep all of the gear and get ready to shoot.
Thank you so much to Eugene and Didi for the hospitality. Right here, the chauffeur, everything has been absolutely amazing. I can't wait to ride tomorrow.
I was fortunate enough to have an interview with Mr. Arturo Sansom, product marketing manager of Moto Guzzi, so that he can tell me more about the bike. Apart from representing the engine capacity, the 100 in the V100 Mandello is also representing Moto Guzzi's step into the next century of the brand, having just celebrated their first centennial in 2021. At the heart of the V100 lies the brand new liquid-cooled 1042cc 90-degree transverse V-twin engine, a big departure from Guzzi's traditional air-cooled design. It also comes with a whole host of tech upgrades that we're used to seeing from other brands, but not traditionally from Moto Guzzi. Apart from a semi-active suspension setup and cornering ABS, the V100 is also the first in the world to have adaptive aerodynamics. From this description alone, doesn't it sound like a sports bike? Will Moto Guzzi be coming out with a sports bike next?
Well, of course, I cannot disclose, but a new engine, when you develop a new engine platform, usually you use it thinking about different application. And yeah. I can tell you, this engine has an impressive torque and a sporty character, so it can fit in many other different bikes. What we wanted with this bike was really having a bike to bring Moto Guzzi to the next chapter. So of course we have the iconic Guzzis, again, where we emphasize the authenticity, the air-cooled engine, but this one wanted to be still a Guzzi, but bringing the brand toward the future.
So it's the day of the ride, and we have this care package from Moto Guzzi. Very nice touch. Supposedly, we're supposed to wear a t-shirt that's inside here. The sporty side of travel. Looking at the photos, I thought the V100 would be sort of an adventure tour crossover, but it seems like it's more towards the sportier side. I'm really excited to try it out because the more I look at it, right, the more it's growing on me. Like, it looks good. Oops. Oh, nice. Hello. Wolverine?
Wait, huh? No way! Wait, what? Is this an actual Marvel? Whoa.
That's the V7.
Ah, yes. The formula that can never go wrong. Comic books, superheroes, motorcycles, and...
Well, this is actually my favorite thing of the whole package. I am going to be probably framing this up because that is very cool.
Oh, okay. I'm going to get dressed. I'm excited for the ride.
Nice one, Mo. Holy shit, I love this brand. Okay, we're gonna start moving out. I'm damn excited to go and ride that. Holy shit.
Oh, okay. I see what I really want to see. The special edition F-35 inspired V-100. Oh my god. What is it called? Air Force Navale? Oh my god, the detail on this bike is amazing. I wanna touch it.
Jaco?
Yes.
Number 5?
Awesome.
And then this is your bike number, isn't it?
Okay, thank you.
Number
2. Over the jacket, right? Alright, thank you. V100s are over there. I wonder if I'm getting the S. It doesn't matter. I want to ride it. Oh, it's the S. And it's my favorite color out of all. Oh, this is perfect.
Ah, it looks so good. What the? Yeah, let's go. Here we go, first start. Oh, you got that pull to the left. Oh my god. Wait, we're going one by one? Shit, if I stall, I swear. Oh my god, please don't stall. Please don't stall. This is so stressful. Why would you do this? Let's feel the bike. Okay. Shit, it feels good. Okay, this is the thing I don't like about quick shift. That's like, I don't like how when you're shifting manually, everything feels a bit squishy. And this is for all quick shifters that I've tried. All the way from the BMW, Ducati, Moto Guzzi, Yamaha. All of them. I don't like quick shifters, dude. Like, why? Bit of a delay, but not too bad. Still very snappy. You see like the bike just going. Woo! Woo! I don't like windshields though, so go down, go away. Get out of my view. Yeah, boy, let's go. First impressions, I get it. It's really like a mix between a tourer and a street bike. Oh, this seat got power, dude. Okay, let's try the, it's up down, so. Oh, that's smooth. Oh, that's smooth. That is a very nice quick shifter. Holy crap. Very nice quick shifter, actually. Holy crap. Very smooth. I was shifting at what? 2000 RPM, 3000 RPM? Shifting down at 3000 RPM from second to first, it didn't. Wow, okay. Handling is. She feels light. This is a 1000cc machine. Push her up. Oh, I feel a difference, but I like the wind. So go back down, please. Wait, this is not on. Okay, let's see. We're in tour mode. Oh, it's on now. Oh, this is sport mode. Okay. Very, whoa, you feel that? Damn, very nice to stand and ride this bike. Very comfortable. We're on the poles now. I'm in third and it's still not like, you know, choking out. Oh, like that. Wow! That front brake, dude! Holy shit! What a nice front brake.
I think what they were saying between mixing it with a roadster and a tourer, like they've really nailed it.
Yeah, they really have.
So we're at the first stop right now, BHP. I'm a bit at a loss for words because the bike is really, really, really nice. It's not what I expected from a Guzzi at all. Excited to go up to Genting. It's gonna be fun.
Okay, let's try to push it open. And then switch over. Oh, that's nice! Wow! Man, what a flickable machine. Whoa! That's scraped, dude. That's scraped up. I have to say, even on Genting, this bike is hot. I can feel the heat between my legs. So stop-go city riding would be pretty painful, I think. Like, I can feel the heat right at my ankles. Nice! Dude, the suspension just go. You know what Mark said about not seeing a hump and then just throttling it a little bit? And just go. The suspension are cream. Orleans. This is my favorite part about the entire trip. I wish I was riding this back to Singapore. It would be a very nice ride to ride this back to Singapore alone. This is such a. You can be such a hooligan on this thing! What the hell? It's just the torque that immediate. You know? The ground clearance though. My pegs are scraping.
I'm scraping the pegs all over the place, man. What the f- Okay, this is the first time I'm going down Genting with like such heavy clouds everywhere. Oh, this will be fun. Very nice engine brake actually. Like on my XSR, going down Genting in first gear, second gear, when I close the throttle, it just goes. But for this, it's a gradual slow. It feels a little bit like I'm just using my rear brake, that's it. Which is nice. Oh, this is one of the fun corners. While going slow, it's pretty beautiful as well. Like, go to the edge, and let's look at that. It's gorgeous, dude. This bike makes for a very good twisty road adventure bike. Comfortable, yet flickable, maneuverable. Even with the 190 rear. Yeah, okay, actually I'm very surprised by that. Even with the 190 rear, it feels so nimble. Interesting.
We pulled into a light gravel path that led to an opening to have a short break with some freshly made espresso drinks and snacks before continuing on our way back to Motoplex. But not before a few of us swapped bikes to try the other version of the V100. The perfect excuse for me to get rid of the quick shifter on the V100S and try the standard version.
Oh, this is so much nicer! Yep, I still hate quick shifters. Yep. If I get this bike, I'm getting the non-S version, dude. Suspension on this feels quite soft. It's in the S version, it's Olin's, so can't really compare. Color-wise, yeah, the S looks better. Oh, I love the sound of the twin at like low revs. Going along like a helicopter, if I get this bike, definitely getting an aftermarket exhaust. Definitely lowering the handlebars. Shit, man, Eugene, what have you done to me? Oh, that sounds so good. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Yeah, oh, hello. I would have to say the sports version of this bike really handles a lot sharper because of the suspension, purely because of the suspension. But in terms of quick shifter, I still don't like quick shifters, so I'm not the best person to ask about that. Don't get me wrong, if you're someone who likes quick shifters, it's a very, very nice quick shifter. I just don't like quick shifters. Let's get back before the big weather, water starts coming down from the sky. I don't want to say the word. If you guys know, it's a bit pantang. Pantang meaning just common superstition. Don't say the R word when you don't want the R to come down. Okay? Capish? Okay. Okay, yeah, the suspension is not set up properly. It's bouncing. Oh, but this is, oh boy.
Okay, we're back from the ride and it's now raining. So the second group is about to go out. They're gonna be riding in the rain, trying out the rain mode, I guess. Hopefully the rain subsides quickly so that they can have as much fun as we had on the bikes. So I asked Eugene, and there is a Mandero S registered for demo. So we will be able to test ride that bike and do a review for you guys. So keep a watch out for that.
With that, my Moto Guzzi V100 experience came to a close. It really was an intricately presented event that showcased the brand fully and sets the tone on how Moto Guzzi sees themselves in the next 100 years. With safety vehicles and marshals aplenty keeping us safe, even guests who are unfamiliar with KL roads were able to ride with a peace of mind. Not to mention the abundance of food, drinks, and entertainment. I definitely look forward to attending another Moto Guzzi event. If you enjoyed our content, consider subscribing and leaving a comment. With that, I'm Jake, and we'll see you on the road.